I am Jean-Marie Glazer, welcoming you to Live at Timucua. Tonight, we feature L'Histoire du Soldat, The Soldier's Tale. Conceived by Igor Stravinsky and Swiss writer C.F. Ramuz, the piece was based on a Russian folktale. The libretto relates the parable of a soldier who trades his fiddle to the devil in return for unlimited economic gain. This Timucua version does not have the actors or dancers, only the narrator, played by Cole NeSmith. Therefore, we added some text from Roger Waters' version, because it better tells the tale without the actors or dancers to play the parts. Conducted by Thad Anderson, we hope that you will enjoy Timucua's version of L'Histoire du Soldat. Please, take the time to go to timucua.com to help support these performers who are all struggling right now. Just click on the donate button. Thanks, and enjoy! This Timucua broadcast is made possible by One Florida Bank, by Opera Orlando, by Park Ave CDs, by Plush Recording Studios. Please, let them know that you appreciate their support for Timucua. Our visual artist for July is Roberto Gonzalez. A native of Mexico City, Roberto has been on a lifelong, introspective journey in search of the appropriate outlet to share his rich heritage and passion for life with others. Each painting delivers an inner peace that is passed from artist to viewer as Roberto takes them on their own personal voyage of discovery inside his imaginative world of Impressionism. Roberto describes his unique artistic style as fluid movement from which flows the essence of life, and enjoys using vibrant colors, unusual movement with acrylics, and oil on canvas to bring his vision to life. Should you be interested in talking to Roberto about his art, please contact him directly at artbyrobertogonzalez.com.
Down a hot and dusty road tramps a soldier with his load. He has to spend. Will his journey never end? Marching home, marching on his way. Marching, marching all the day. Soon he will be home to stay. This isn't a bad sort of spot. Join the army. I've had my lot. Always on trek, not a penny to bless. Struth, my kit's in a hell of a mess. Where's my St. Joseph? He looks in his pack for a lucky medallion he has with the face of his namesake, St. Joseph, engraved on the back. Good, there we are. He starts rummaging, brings out cartridges, rummages on. Here's a mirror with most of the silvering gone. Where's her picture? That mustn't be missed. The picture his girlfriend gave him the day he went off to enlist. Ah, here it is. And right in the middle, he brings out an old brown fiddle. It didn't cost much. The tone's not rich. You have to keep screwing it up to pitch.
Thank you.
As you can hear, the soldier plays very well. Even out here on the back of Beyond, he's attracted an audience. A little old man who carries a butterfly in it. A little old man, dear friends, who is, in fact, the devil. The devil stops to listen for a while. He's intrigued. He quietly approaches the soldier and touches his arm. The soldier startles, springs back in alarm. Aye, you gave me a fright. Give me your fiddle. No. Sell it to me. No. I'll give you this book for it, then. Can't read. Makes no difference. There's no need. With this book, you don't have to read. It's more than a book. It's wealth untold. You've only to open it, lo and behold, banknotes, bearer bonds, and gold. Well, I should... like to have a look? Certainly. Certainly. Here's your book. On sight, collateral, note of hand. The book's not easy to understand. I can read it all right, but it's all Greek to me. You'll get the hang of it. Just wait and see. But look, if it's worth all this money, sir, this little job, that old fiddle of mine, it only costs a few bob. So you've a real bargain. Right then, it's a deal. On sight, collateral, note of hand, market quotations for Friday the 31st. What's today's date? It's Tuesday. Why, it's Tuesday the 28th. What's this? This here book is ahead of the date. A strange sort of book. It tells you things before they happen. Come home with me. Now, what do you say? Why, what's up? This thing won't play. You must teach me to make it go. I've only 10 days leave, you know. I shall lend you a carriage and a pair. If you walk, you'll be much more slow. Well, mother will worry if I'm late. It's not the first time she's had to wait. And my girlfriend, she expects me too. You'll make it up to her soon. She'll be more pleased when you do. This place of yours, is it abroad? Wined, dined, all found, full bed and board. Home in a carriage like a lord, 2 or 3 days a step out of your way, and then you'll be as rich as the king of Cathay. What sort of victuals down your way? Steak, egg and chips 3 times a day, and to drink champagne rosé. Smoking permitted? What do you say to Havana? Havana cigars, now what do you say? Well, there you are then. That's the way. That's how you want it. That's the trick. Joseph's off home with old Nick, and he finds that the old boy doesn't cheat. New clothes, soft beds, and plenty to eat. Yes, Joseph is properly done up to treat. And each shows the other as they undertook the way of the fiddle and the way of the book. Yes, the old fellow kept his word. 2 days well spent, then came the third. That morning, the old man wakes Joseph as soon as it's light, and he says, "Are you ready?" And Joseph says, "Right. Did you have a good night?" And Joseph says, "Yes." And the devil looks on as he gets up to dress. "Have you any complaints?" And Joseph says, "Nope. Right you are," says old Nick. "Then off we go." They get in the carriage waiting below, and the devil says, "Hup," and off they go. Only Joseph, watching the horse's flying feet, finds himself holding on with both hands to his seat with all his might till his knuckles are white. "Hold tight," yells the old man, "hold tight." Joseph would like to get up and jump out, but he doesn't have a chance. "Take care," cries the devil. "See how my horses prance? They'll lead us a dance. They're taking us into the air. Take care." And the carriage is suddenly traveling up in the air, hurtling, rattling, rolling round the sky, and Joseph's hair stands on end as he nearly faints. "Have you any complaints? Have you any complaints?" Higher and higher over the valley and hill, faster and faster, up, up they soar, still till time stands still. Then everything is as it was before. Down a hot and dusty road tramps a soldier with his load. Ten days leave he has to spend. Will his journey never end? Marching home, marching on his way. He's been marching all the day. Happy now he's home to stay. Hurrah, here we are. We're home at last. "Good morning, Miss Gray." She's in the garden. "Hello there, how's the world with you?" She doesn't hear me. Never mind. There's Arthur. "Hey, Arthur, hey, Arthur." He's mowing the 5-acre meadow, a good old friend and true. Oh, what's the matter? He doesn't reply. "Arthur, hi, don't you know me? Why, it's Joseph, Joseph the soldier, Joe. You remember him, you know." The mower mows on and on we go, and there's the school with the tower and bell. "Joseph, old Joe, you remember him well. Here's the mill and the inn. Now villagers everywhere. Men, women, and children, they stand and stare. What's the matter? What's up with the lot of you? What's got into you all? Are you afraid of me or what? You know me, all you there, Joseph." No one speaks. And then a door slams. And another slams. And more and more. and the rusty hinges shriek as every door slams shut. Huh, that's funny, he thinks. But Mother will know. I better go. She sees him coming. She screams and runs away, and he thinks, there's my fiancée. Married? With two children? The dirty cheat. The dirty, rotten cheat. I know who you are at last. I know what's happened. I know you. I've taken my time about it, too. It wasn't 3 days. 3 years have passed. They'll take me for a ghost. I'm dead among the living. Oh, the cheat. The dirty, rotten, and like a fool, I went and listened to him. Yes, I know I was tired and hungry, but that's no reason to go listening to the likes of him. Do you take any notice of what people you don't know tell you? No. You say, I don't know you, but what do? I listen to him. I should have had my suspicions, but no, I listened to him like a fool. I had to go and listen to him, and I gave him my fiddle. Oh, of all the luck. Now what am I going to do? What am I going to do now? What am I going to do now? The soldier, disconsolate, depressed, has left the village of his birth and wanders aimlessly about the countryside, no longer feeling a connection to the earth, severed From his roots, like liquid on a hill, he takes the path of least resistance. No hope, no plan until one day. By chance, he stumbles upon the very man, the cause of all of his trouble, the bane of his whole life, is right there at the roadside, nonchalantly leaning on a cane. The soldier draws his bayonet and rushes to attack. The devil, quite unmoved, implacable, stands his ground and just stares back. Oh, you dirty cheat, it's you! Now what are you going to do? You dirty, dirty, rotten cheat! Please be a little more discreet. Do try and behave. Do you hear me? You? Good. Now what are you going to do? Have you forgotten all I said? The book I gave you bound and read? It's in my kit. Then you've got all you need, if you've still got it. And aren't you a soldier? Then be one, then. Show these ladies and gentlemen. On guard, a tin chun, that's it. Pull that up, break ranks, and stow your kit. There we are, platoon, fall in and run at ease. Stand easy, a tin chun, platoon, off caps. Here, take this one of mine. Not bad, it suits you fine. Now, take off your tunic, unbutton the throat. Don't fall out, we'll find you a coat. Don't fall out! We've hardly begun, you're not finished. Attention, the book, now what have you done? Oh yes, you told me, well, fetch it then. No, only the book. Now back here again. Oh, be careful, don't let it come to harm. You'll lose it like that, put it under your arm. That book, it's worth a fortune, you'd see. Hold on to it tight and listen to me. This mine here, that yours there, each to his own, and so all is square. He took the book and began to read. And the words meant money, and more money, and still more money, as much as a man could need. He used it first to set right his affairs, and became a peddler, a seller of wares. Come along, ladies, come by, for there's all shades and sizes. Black, navy, pale blue, Prussian blue, pastel, sky blue, beige, chocolate, fawn, dark gray, 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 pale gray, silver gray, russet, maroon, brown, khaki, unbleached, linen by the yard, printed cottons, crepe de chine, silks and satins, pre-war prices. A peddler first, a seller of wares for a start. Then he needs no goods. He knew it all by heart. Things go the way I make them go. For others only guess, I know. It's more than a book, it's wealth untold. You've only to open it low and behold, you can have all you want, all your heart's desire, all the best things in life, anything you require while you have time. Quick, grab all you can. One day you'll be dead, you're only a man. No, my old friend, you didn't lie, because in the end, we've all got to die. First one thing and then another, I've only to say this, that, and the other, because I can pay, it's all mine, all. He stops. All. Nothing. All nothing. Nothing at all. What have I said? What's the matter with me? I have everything. Nothing. Now he can see. All you want, all the time, all wealth can provide, and they don't mean a thing. They are empty inside. False things, dead, rotten. You buy, you sell, they are nothing. Just an empty shell. You have to still the things you have before. The real, the true, good things that everybody has but you. That you have no more, the only things worth having. Just to stretch out on the grass as you used to do, good to touch, good to feel, things that cost nothing that everyone has. That means so much. These things are real, things that belong to all the world but you. Saturday evening, weekend plans, watching the village at work in its garden, so many people with watering cans, the little girls playing Tom Tiddler's ground. You smile as you pass along the sun-baked wall. You settle down on the grass and someone fills your glass. Things that are warm inside, the only ones worth having. They have nothing. And yet they have it all. And I, who have everything, oh, I have nothing. 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 How can it be? Oh, Satan. Satan, you've cheated me. Oh, what can I do? Oh, what does it say in the book? He snatches it up and he starts to look. You must know. Tell me how everyone, how all the others are happy. How is it done? You must know. You must tell me. Explain. What can I do to have nothing again? The telephone rings. Hello, sir. With regard to your current account, sir. Later. The telephone rings. Later, I tell you, later. The book, it must know the secret. Then answer me, what can I do to be as I used to be? I have been proud and envied. And in my pride, I am dead inside to the world outside. I am rich, unbelievably rich. Rich, but all I'd give to be alive again as others live. I am a ghost among the living. Please, kind sir, can I come in? What do you want? Just a few words with you, sir, before I begin. If you'll allow me, you seem to have dropped something, sir, you might miss. Now, what do you want? I'll explain, sir. It's this. I have a little case outside full of rare, precious things, sir. I'd be glad. No, thank you. Sir, for pity's sake, here, take this. Sir, we have our pride. Nothing for nothing is the rule. Each has his little job to do. My case is outside, sir. You'll please let me go and bring it in to you. Now, look, sir. Look at these lovely things. Watches, necklaces, and rings. Some lace, sir? No. Don't be afraid, sir, to say so. It's true, of course, you haven't a wife. Each has his little job in life. A lucky medallion engraved on the back. No. No, every time. Now, what do you lack? A mirror, perhaps? No. Oh, dear, what a shame. A beautiful picture, complete with frame? Ah, that seems to arouse your interest. Is it still no? Still the same as the rest, or would? A fiddle be best. How much? How much, I say? Well, as we're friends, I won't stand in the way. Try it first. See what you say. We'll fix a price. Let's hear you play. The soldier takes the violin from the devil and tries to play, but sadly, his talent has deserted him. He whips round, but the devil has gone. In a rage, he hurls the violin to the ground. Bloody violin, piece of shite, no bloody good at all in this bloody book. Bloody hell, that can F off and all. He picks up the book and painstakingly, page by page, shreds it into 1,000 pieces. A hot and dusty road tramps a man without his load. Someone trudging on and on, many, many miles he's gone. Over hill and dale he goes. Where he's heading, no one knows. He doesn't even know himself. He only knows he must get out to somewhere else because he can't go on the way he was. Nothing remains of all his fine belongings. He's thrown them out without a word to say to anyone. He's run away. And things are just the way they were, except, of course, he has no pack to bear. Is he taking the homeward road? The road he took before? Home? No, it's not his anymore. Now he goes the other way. Cannot say, on his way, marches on all day. Now he comes to another land, a village in the frontier, and an inn. He thinks, shall I cross over? And he thinks, why not? He goes to the inn, orders a tot, drinks it down. Yes, and now what? Then he begins to look around. He gazes at the muslin curtains bound with silk cord. Fine white muslin, scarlet cord, such fine white muslin curtains pinned around the leaded window panes where the leaves stir in the wind. But what's this? Suddenly, the world outside comes crashing in again. Somebody starts to beat a drum. And someone beats a drum because the princess of the realm, the only daughter of the king, lies ill in bed. She neither sleeps, nor speaks, nor eats, nor anything, and the king proclaims to the sound of the drum that whosoever man shall come and raise his daughter from her bed, that man the fair princess shall wed. Just at that moment, a man comes up to Joseph. Hello, chum. We've not been introduced, it's true, but, well, I've been a soldier too. Old comrades don't mind if you make yourself known. When I saw you come in and you were alone, I said to myself, have a word with him. He looks a bit down, I said. You can see at a glance. Go on over. Who knows, this may be his big chance. A lovely young girl. What about it? A princess, too. Think of that. I'd say it was made for you. I'm married already. Worse luck, it's no use to me. But you, my lad, you're young, you're free. doctoring, well, that's whatever you choose. Besides, you know, you've nothing to lose by trying. You go, you say, I'm an M.O., she's cured, she's not. It's worth a shot. Why not? After all, why not? Goodbye, old chap. Many thanks for the tip. He's up, he's out, quick as a whip. He's up, he's off. He makes his way to the palace gates. He gives a ring. Where are you going? The sentries say. Where am I going? To see the king. Arranged for the very next day. In a room in the palace where the princess lay, courtiers, of course, and the king was on hand. And up in the gallery, a 7-piece band, our hero was there, keen to begin. But there was another suitor, small, old, and thin. But what made him stand out was the worrying thing. Under his arm, tucked lovingly in, he carried a small brown violin. They gave word for the band to play. The king received me, the king no less, he said. You are a doctor? I said, an army doctor, yes. Many have come, you know, but none have stayed. Oh, I have my methods, I said. I'm not dismayed. Well, tomorrow you shall see the princess. It went off just as we thought it would. That fellow was right. So far, so good. Just think, a girl to call your own, and after so many years alone. Why not? Why shouldn't the luck be mine? Ask the cards. What do you say? 6 of hearts. 10 of hearts. Queen of hearts. Nothing but harps. Hearts, trumps all the way. It's true. Why not? Why shouldn't it be? I'll have a wife of my own, only for me, and what's more, a princess, too. Someone's here ahead of you. You were silly to be upset. You were rich and esteemed. You get a sudden whim, don't count the cost, and now, my poor young friend, you're lost. Six of hearts, ten of hearts, hearts all the way. You told yourself it's my lucky day. Well, do you still believe it's true? I have my methods, I, not you. It's true what he says. He's got me for sure. He'll do the trick. He's got the cure. I have nothing at all. Nothing once more. Go for him. Just the same. Knock him down. Bang his head on the floor. He isn't a man. I can do nothing more. You can, I tell you. You can. Don't you see how it is? He's got you because of the money. You have his money. Get rid of that and you're saved. Go on, begin. Offer to play him at cards. He's sure to win. Will you play? I have money. What? I don't understand. I said, would you like a game? My dear young friend, I'm always ready for a hand. He'll win. He always likes to win. You'll lose. He'll be lost. Begin. Notes, gold and silver, they're all in. Good. How much to a point? A farthing, yes. Sixpence to a point, not a penny less. Just as you wish, but take care. No more fiddle, no more book. Only a few pennies left, and look. The pennies are flying into the air. You'll have nothing at all. Then where will you be? You'll starve, my friend. S-T-A-R-V-E. There, you see, total defeat. You'll go around naked, no shoes on your feet. Raise him a pound. A pound? You're mad. How can you beat 10 pounds? Deal on. Gently, gently, not so fast. I've won, same as last. Stake the lot. I stake the lot. Ace of spades, and you've got the queen of hearts? Again, it's me, I've won. Again. You see, he's going to fall. I said he would. Listen, get up, here's what to do. Give him a drink. It'll do him good. Say to him, here's a health to you. Take this, it'll do you good. Go on, have a drink, say when. Here's health to you, and again. Very, very rude. That's not at all the... Look out, he's going to fall. I am free, I'm free. Now, do I dare? He's not quite out, be careful there. Oh, it's like that. All right then, 8, 9, 10. Now, take back your own again. Floods the eastern sky, a new day dawns. The cloud over the kingdom, it lifts, shutters swing back. Ah, a scent of hope hangs sweet upon the breeze. In the palace corridors, courtiers, very eager to please, flit hither and thither. Birds sing. Crowds throng at the palace gates. Mothers, fathers, children on shoulders. The sergeant polishes his buttons in the sun. The townsfolk jostle for a better view. Something's coming, something new. Princess, now we can safely say, he who will cure you is on the way. Soon now he's going to come to you, because there's nothing he can't do. Soon now he'll be outside your door, because he's found himself once more. Soon now he'll come to claim his wife, because he has been brought back to life. He's going to bring you back to life. With a confident air, enters the princess's room, takes out his violin, makes sure it's in tune, tucks the instrument snugly under his chin, takes a deep breath, and begins. The princess lies unmoving like a corpse, but when he plays, she stirs. She turns her head, opens her eyes. She breathes, and then she smiles. She yawns, and then laughs, and sits up as if waking from a trance, and shaking out her auburn hair, she takes the floor to dance.
Thank you.
At first, a tango, then a waltz, and finally, a ragtime. The star-crossed lovers swoon, intertwined, besotted. They dance to each and every tune. The devil tries to stop them, but his efforts are in vain. He tries to grab the fiddle, but to no avail. Alas, dear friends, at last the soldier has his day, and when he plays, the devil, with no power left in him, is forced to cavort like a marionette, like a puppet on a string.
Thank you.
The devil, confused, frustrated, incapacitated by drink and defeat, staggers about like a drunk on the street. He tries to resist, but in vain. His legs won't obey him. He's practically lame. In effect, it's over. The battle is done. It seems that our soldier and his new bride have won. Devil recovers some of his wits. He may be exhausted, subject to fits, but he is nonetheless still in the end, still obsessed with thoughts of revenge. All right, I shall have to wait, but this realm of yours is not so great. If once its frontier should be passed, then you'll be in my power at last. So do not push your luck too far, and then, my lady, you will find that you are back in bed again. As for her prince, he can't be pretend. He doesn't know my patience now is at an end. He who laughs the last, he laughs most, as I shall do to watch him roast. A fair warning from the devil. But like the pain of an old wound, over time, fair warnings fade. Must not seek to add to what you have, what you once had. You have no right to share what you are with what you were. Can have it all. That is forbidden. You must learn to choose between. One happy thing is every happy thing. Two is as if they had never been. I have everything, he thinks. I always will have everything, he thinks. But one day she says, I know so little about you still. Tell me about yourself. Come on, tell me. Well, it all started a long, long time ago. There was a cottage I shared with my mother. I was a soldier then, you know, far, far away. I've almost forgotten where. Suppose we go there. No, it is forbidden. Suppose we go. We'd be back before we were missed. No one would ever know. She looks at him and smiles and says, you want to go. I can see you do. It isn't much to ask of you. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Why not? You want to. I can see you do. He says, come over here to me, not until you say yes. And so he thinks, well, if we did go, perhaps this time mother will know me. Why not? Just pay a call and she could come live with us. Then I shall have it all. They're on their way. They're nearly there. A scent, he knows, hangs in the air. He has gone on ahead to find the frontier. She is a little ways behind. He calls her, and then he turns back, and then changes his mind. Alas, he cannot help himself. Despite foreboding in the air, oblivious of old constraints, he steps across the line, and there, leaning patient on his cane, the soldier's worst nightmare. Head inclined in condescension, wearing his best smug Sunday grin, the devil beckons him with crooked finger and leads him down to Hades with a small brown violin.
Thank you.
you just watched tonight's edition of Live at Timucua. Please, go to timucua.com and donate. We will share the proceeds with the performers. Thanks!